community, and that community becomes true champions, it also impacts lives for many years to come.
Questions to ask your father, because I think a lot of men, like, they don't really know their dads. They don't really know anything about what they were like when they were kids, what were their dreams, what were their goals as young men, what did they think about becoming a dad. Like, you don't know that stuff, and it'd be nice to know that stuff because you're going through that stuff yourself.
Totally agree, and I was so fortunate. Again, it was one of these unexpected gifts. We were sitting in Joe's office at his church. Back then he was a pastor of a large church, about 4,000 members in Baltimore. We were sitting in his office one day having one of these conversations related to this program as I was learning more for the writing of this book. And he took a phone call, and I started looking at the books on his bookshelf this day, and I was so fortunate just to stumble across this book, and when he was done on the phone, I asked him about it, he told me about it, how he had used it with his boys, and he said, go ahead, take it, you know, you might enjoy it, check it out. Well, I did, I enjoyed it quite a bit, and I ended up using that as a blueprint for my own conversations with my dad, and it was really incredible to see not only the way that helped us along, but once I wrote about that in the book, Season of Life, there were so many other families around America who I would get emails and calls, and when I would go out for speaking engagements, one of the first things I would hear from people would be how they, too, ended up using those questions and having similar conversations as a father and son that took people in so many wonderful directions. So it was an incredible gift that Joe gave to me, and then I was able to share that with other people. So that's been a pretty special part of this as well.
Jeff, this has been a great conversation. Where can people learn more about your work and your book?
Well, both the book Season of Life, and then I do a lot of work still, speaking engagements related to these topics, and all of that information can be found on the website, jeffreymarks.org. That's just one solid word, jeffreymarks, M-A-R-X, like x-ray, .org. And then to follow the journey, I really came to see this as a journey, not only as a book anymore, but all these years and all these experiences. I try to share that with folks through the Twitter account, which is at JeffreyMarks25. JeffreyMarks25.
Fantastic. Well, Jeffrey Marks, thank you so much for your time. It's been a pleasure.
Tremendous. Thank you, Brett. Enjoy it.
My guest name is Jeffrey Marks. He's the author of the Pulitzer Prize winning book, Season of Life. It's available on Amazon.com and bookstores everywhere. You can find out more information about Jeffrey's work at JeffreyMarks.org. Also, check out our show notes at aom.is/seasonoflife, where you can find links to resources where you can delve deeper into this topic. Up another edition of the Art of Manliness podcast. For more manly tips and advice, make sure to check out the Art of Manliness website at artofmanliness.com. If you enjoy the show, got something out of it, I'd appreciate it if you take 1 minute to give us a review on iTunes or Stitcher. It helps out a lot. As always, thank you for your continued support. Until next time, this is Brett McKay telling you to stay manly.
Thank you. guess that's crushing, I guess.
Let's see.
We need to figure out if there's a way to disable that crap.
Thank you.
keeps going when you go to the home screen. I was just checking what time it is. Probably the only place it's still open is Carl's Jr. and Jack in the Box. Some of those habanero crackers too, huh?
Habanero crackers?
Or chips, I mean. They're really good with that cheese dip.
Yeah.
It's a really interesting flavor combination.
Yeah, maybe I'll have some of those.
Sounds good.
I knew that you really liked them, and they're not marked gluten-free, so I haven't been...
The habanero ones?
Yeah.
Yeah, they are.
Oh, wait.
That's why I bought them.
That's right, I forgot. Well, I knew that you really liked them, and... So I haven't been eating them this week.
Well, I appreciate you saving me some.
And I've just been eating the salted cracker salt? Things.
Yeah.
And the every once in a great while I'll have some of the tortilla chips.